بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. الحمد لله الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. الحمد لله. We are still continuing with our program on PIP, Positive Islamic Psychology, based on our book, Life Coach Training Program. And I have explained to you how we are going to go about to transform the counseling and coaching and mentoring of the Ummah, especially the young people, as we face the challenges in life, right, in the 21st century. And I have given you many videos. So we have given you the whole idea of how a systematic approach towards developing an approach that is integrated for the Ummah, especially in our mosque, Islamic community center, Islamic organization, retreat, and so on, where we start with motivation. So we have, based on this book, Positive Islamic Psychology, we have motivation, and I've given you 135 videos, and I've given more than 200 plus videos on coaching, how to go about coaching. And then we have given also more than 550 videos on counseling. So now we have moved from motivation to coaching. So I have given you the growth model, G-R-O-W-T-H, on coaching. Now I'm going to develop the whole concept of mentoring, because these are skill sets. As we face the challenges of the 21st century, as we face many of the young people who become atheists, who become hedonistic, who live a free-for-all lifestyle, who just go on free sex, free everything, you have to have a very consolidated, integrated, holistic approach to save our young people. And this is where our ustads, our teachers, must be equipped with the skills. They must be equipped with motivational skills. They cannot use the old rod, stick, beating method, no way, or threat method. Alright, then they must have this coaching ability. At a high level, they must be mentoring, because our young people are lost. If we don't mentor them, more and more of our young people will follow the hedonistic Western lifestyle, in which they are lost. So they're going into the lizard hole, and they are dragging our young people along. But we must have a countermeasure. And that countermeasure is a systematic approach. That's why we come up, Professor Mahdi Jenkins. He realized the beauty of Islamic psychology, of being the Caliph of Allah, the metaphysics of Islam, based on the works of Imam Ghazali and all the other great scholars. He spent his whole life trying to bring about this idea of this positive idealism of Islam in the 21st century, based on being the Caliph of Allah, always striving to make ourselves good, helping others to be good, making the world good. Not only for Muslims, non-Muslims, and all goodly creatures on earth. That is our goal. But we must be able to then portray this beautiful deen of forgiveness, of mercy, of compassion, of love throughout the world. And we must be mentoring. No doubt we want to reach out to those people who are not Muslims yet, but within our own house. The whole Ummah is in trauma. Our whole Ummah is facing so many challenges. So we have to do housekeeping. First, we have to make sure that we take care of our Ummah by mentoring, and then, inshallah, counseling at the highest level. So once you are equipped with motivational skills, coaching skill, mentoring skill, counseling skill at this level, you may have to have diploma in counseling or a degree in counseling. And then you can become a psychologist, a social, a psychiatrist, whatever it is. We must then bring this whole group of competent professionals within the Ummah to go about, most importantly, to save our young people. This is our initiative. This is our hope, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless his effort. And within the next 10 years, we will be able to train 12,000 of you all over the world, because that magic number of 12,000 is very important in the Sirah or Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You can change the world with 12,000 people who can help you go on this journey. Yeah. So today I'm going to talk about mentoring, and I'm going to give you the mentoring approach. What is mentoring, and so on. So you have a definition, you have some basic knowledge, and this whole concept of mentoring now, religious mentoring, is now very much adopted by our Christian brothers and sisters. Alhamdulillah, they're quite advanced in their approach in terms of using psychology, all right? But then they are also bringing their religious psychology of their belief system and so on. Well, alhamdulillah, let them do their way, because, as I say, they are facing the greatest problem. The greatest loss of followers is among the Christians. So 90% of the Christians are not actually practicing Christians anymore. So they are just practicing materialism, hedonistic lifestyle, free-for-all lifestyle. They may have a Christian name, but they are not Christian anymore. So they are facing the biggest problem. They are facing the biggest fire. But we have our own house, this same tendency. So we have to then approach this from a purely Islamic, positive Islamic psychology approach, using our basis of Iman, Islam and Ihsan, and our metaphysics. So I'm going to dwell on mentoring for quite a few videos to give you the whole conceptual approach of what is mentoring, so that you know that when we go about with it, oh, you have an idea, okay. Oh, this is the skill set that we must try to bring about. And using that, we can help millions of our young people who are lost or about to be lost, and take preventive counter measure to ensure that this deen becomes a thriving, beautiful deen in the 21st century, blessed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with his nur, with his light, with his guidance, with his grace, with so many wonderful things that inshallah we will be able to do. So let's start the journey with mentoring. I remember level 1 is motivation, level 2 is coaching, level 3 is mentoring, and then level 4 is counseling. So we'll dwell on this for quite a few videos and give you an idea about mentoring, okay? So when we talk about mentoring, you must have a definition. What is mentoring from the perspective of a religious setting? So there are many definitions. For example, a protected relationship with religious and social values and learning can occur. So this is where we have the mentor and the mentee. So normally the mentor can be somebody who is either a bit older or much older, which is, we have this relationship. I'll explain to you from the Islamic mentorship, which has happened since the days of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam at Darul Arkam. We have already mentorship program started by Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So it's not a new thing. So when you talk about mentorship, oh, is this something newfangled thing? No, it is done by Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Only thing, along the way we lost our way, so we go back to the way of the Sunnah. All right. So mentoring is a way of Sunnah. Another definition of mentoring: a mutual relationship with an international agenda designed to convey specific content along with life wisdom from one individual to another. So you may have a person who's more experienced in life, he's trying to bring about this deen. And our ustaz are doing that, but maybe not on an individual basis, but on a group basis and so on. But the relationship aspect may not be that close, but some of them are quite close, maybe between the sheikh and the student. That is mentoring. All right. Mentoring also is a supportive learning relationship between a caring individual and who shares his religious and social values. So we share our religious and social values to our young people who are lost. They go to university, suddenly they say, they go home, they say, I'm going today and I don't believe in God anymore, I'm an atheist, because my professor says religion is all nonsense. All right. So this elder person, the parents cannot handle, so we have our coach. But now the coach has to build a relationship. So a deeper relationship is what we call mentoring. It's just like, for example, the difference between coaching and mentoring. Let's take football. Okay, for example, you have this football team. So the coach is teaching all the football team members, all of them. So he is the football coach. He has a whole team of footballers under his care, and he teaches them all the skills and whatever it is. So he's a coach. But then there'll be one person there who has so tremendous potential. So he could be another Ronaldo. All right. So this coach says, no, Ayuka, I mentor you. So that is the difference. Coaching is quite broad-based. Mentoring is a relationship between the person who has this. He saw the potential in that person. So we see the potential in our young people to become good, upright, wonderful Muslimin and Muslimat. So we see in them the joy of Iman, Islam and Ihsan. So we want to mentor them. So we have a supportive learning relationship between a caring individual that shares his religion, social values, his knowledge, his experience and wisdom with another individual who's ready and willing to benefit from this exchange to enrich their life on this earth. So as a Muslim, our goal is to return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in that state of Iman, Islam and Ihsan, in the state of peace and tranquility, in the state of nafsul mutmainnah. So that is our goal. So we have to bring not only ourselves, our family, our children, our friends, our mentee. So you are a mentor, you have the whole sense of this deep love to save this person, to share whatever that you have gone through life in a way that is useful. All right, then another definition is the purpose of mentoring is always to help the mentee to change something. So you want to change maybe in his attitude towards life, maybe in terms of his success as a, in career, to improve their performance. That means their performance in terms of their ibadah, performance in terms of their attitude towards their career, their studies and so on, to develop their leadership qualities. So we give them, mentor them on the natural leadership qualities and to develop their partnership skills and to realize their vision, mission, whatever there is in life that bring them closer and closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and becoming an achiever in life. So our motivational module has covered that. If we go back to our motivational module, we have 135 videos that gives you the necessary skill set to motivate an individual. Inshallah, we have our model, all right, 6PGNL in our motivational. Each and every one of them is designed to give this person possibilities of becoming an achievers in life, successful in life, in this world, and also successful in the hereafter. So once we have this understanding of a definition, then we can then start on with a deeper aspect of mentoring. So inshallah, this first video is just to give you this whole understanding, this very important message. We have to change to bring in coaching, mentoring, and positive Islamic psychology into the lives of all Muslimin and Muslimat, all mosques, all Islamic community centers, all Islamic NGOs, to come up with a way forward, most and foremost, to save our youth from becoming lost in this dunya and lost in the akhirah. This is a very sad thing, because we do not want them to suffer in this world and then suffer in the akhirah. So the trauma that we face as individual, the trauma that we face as an ummah right now, we find via media, which is pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I hope these videos on mentoring will give you some framework for us to serve the ummah. Remember, whatever little knowledge that you have, whatever little skills that you have, do something. Give back something, because we are not going to go to heaven alone. We have to bring all our friends, our families, our community with us. Only then can we be safe in this world and the hereafter, inshallah. Always knowing that we are, based on our positive psychology, we are the Caliph Abdu, or the servant of Allah and his Khalifa on this earth, always striving to make ourselves good, helping others to be good, making the world good, inshallah.